Hey guys, this is Latia, and this is my review for Domina, Season 1 and 2. Ooh, I'm so excited to talk about this series because it's a series that I actually really love and I want to share with you guys that I really hope you guys get to check it out. I rarely, you know, find a series where I'm just like, I love it. I'm always looking for a diamond in the rough, and they're very hard to find. I found this through a podcast I listened to called The Rest is History. This is a history podcast hosted by Dominic Sandbrook and Tom Holland. Tom Holland, the historian, not Tom Holland, the Spider-Man. And they were discussing the series of Domina and how, one of them is very much a Roman historian and covering the empire, etc. And he was praising it for being quite accurate, and even going into things like how they address how Romans brushed their teeth back in the day, or how Romans used the bathroom, things that you never really get to see, you know, how people live in historical times. Usually it's always modernized or they don't discuss it at all. And so I was like, I need to check this out. Unfortunately, this TV show is only on two networks. Sky Network, which I think if you're in the UK or Europe, you might have access to it, maybe even Australia. But over here in the US, MGM Plus is the only one that has it. And I was just thinking, oh, I kept waiting. I was like, maybe Netflix will pick it up. Maybe HBO will pick it up. HBO should definitely pick it up because it is the sister show to Rome. And they go hand in hand together, and they're very much of the same vein. But unfortunately, it's still just on MGM Plus. So, needless to say, I needed to watch it, and I watched it, and I was hooked. From episode, like, season one had already finished, so I was able to binge watch that. And from start to finish, I never had a chance to think. It was constantly going. It is a tale that is full of politics, backstabbing, violence, sex, just machinations, and it's so good. So let me tell you about what this show is. Domina is a show created by Simon Burke, and it follows the history of Rome right after Julius Caesar is assassinated. And there are three kind of power players that are trying to avenge Julius Caesar's assassination. That is his adopted son / nephew, sort of nephew, Gaius, and Gaius's military best friend and military strategist Agrippa, and then Mark Antony. You know, everyone knows Mark Antony. And so the Republic and the once dictator of Julius Caesar, you know, throws the whole thing, the whole of Rome, into this civil war between those who like the idea of one dominant dictator, especially those who are focused more on the military. The military loved him. However, you know, from the politics side, you know, the Republic was like, we need to be restored. And so there's this whole faction. Now, Livia Drusilla, who this show is about, is the daughter of one of the great Claudii family, who were, you know, the backbone of the Republic. She is vastly affected by this upheaval in the Civil War, and she gets pretty much banished for 10 years. And she goes through all this insane amount of trauma, and very much she comes back and it's just like, I am not going to be a helpless person. I'm going to find a way to dig my heels in to a seat of power, and I will not let go of that. And so that is exactly what she does. She ends up finding a way to marry Gaius, who becomes, you know, the first, not really the first emperor of Rome. I guess technically kind of the first emperor of Rome, but I think the official first emperor of Rome is Tiberius, her son. And she has all of the power, and it's all done through back doors and just plotting, manipulations, and it's She's just so good. She's so good. And of course, then it follows the family of Gaius and how he tries to maintain control, especially through the bloodlines, and it becomes this whole, you're going to marry you're going to marry you, and then we're going to create this family, and that family then starts to fight for power, very much Games of Thrones style, where it's just like who's going to come out on top, right? Who's going to maintain power, and if you don't want that person to maintain power, what are you willing to do to make sure that person gets toppled? It's yeah, and so the production value of this is, I think, up to the same quality as Rome. Very amazing sets, and very elaborate set designs, costuming. Whew, so good. The costuming is so good. Hair, makeup, perfect. Like I said, it just feels very true to the time. It doesn't feel like a modernized version of Rome. It feels very much like it belongs exactly where it should be. Like I said, it does show things like how people would brush their teeth back then, what kind of device they would use, how people use the toilet, how they wiped. Ooh. But I love that kind of stuff. It just really down to the nitty-gritty. And Rome kind of tells the story from a plebeian perspective, from the underclass and the military. This shows it from the other side, the patricians, those who have like massive amounts, or who are on the top of the hierarchy. And one of the most interesting aspects is seeing how the patricians have a way of which, a whole establishment of behavior that they have between each other, the role women are supposed to play in that society, the role that masters play versus slaves. The whole Roman Empire was built on the backs of slaves and conquest, like just the entire civilization was based off of conquest, and what that actually meant for the people, and how the patricians benefited from that, and how the slaves were basically used as devices to further the role of the patricians. It's just incredibly accurate in that respect. I love seeing the dynamic between Gaius and Livia because she loves him. However, he has a obsession with power, and she has a secret mission to restore the Republic. So that dynamic is constant between them. And you're, as an audience member, you're kind of in the know. And so you're trying to constantly figure out how is she going to stay on top of this? How is she constantly going to stay on top of this? And then in the subplot, which actually becomes a fairly good amount of the conflict within the show, is all of the younger characters, for example, her two sons, Drusus and Tiberius, Caesar's daughter from a previous marriage with Scribona. Her name is Julia, and her role, Mark Antony's son, how he makes an appearance, and then it's just the way that they ultimately, it's basically a story about her machinations, but also the story about how these young children grow up and how they're going to eventually influence the politics of the future of the Roman Empire. And they do a really good job of kind of starting you slow and then building you up into like interweaving into the story where you're just like, oh yeah, I can see it now, The only complaint I have about the show is that it does time jump quite a bit. The first, don't get too attached to the young versions of, for example, Livia and Gaius, because they age them up very fast, and then you accelerate into the years of which they've already had children and the children are grown up. And then season two, the time jumps happen even faster. It's like 5 years later, 4 years later, so it's to keep up with when major events happen within Roman history, or the history of this time. However, I do feel like I'm like, oh, please slow down. You're gonna outpace like what we have left of the story. But then I also think, well, maybe they need to cover more of the story because who knows if this is gonna get renewed for season three or four. This is not a very popular show. It's very much like Rome, that oh, actually, Rome was popular, but it's so expensive, right? These types of shows are so expensive, and unless it has the audience, they don't tend to last. And I'm like, oh no, please, I need to get, you know, like, this is, we're talking about the great grandmother of Caligula, or the grandmother of Caligula. And you're just like, come on, like, can we please continue on? Because the beauty of the history of Rome, which I'm always like shocked that no one ever covers Rome. Like, it's, you go look and see how many movies or TV shows that they have done about Rome, and you won't find hardly anything. And I think it's because it's so expensive. It's so expensive to do, and to do right, that you hardly ever see it. So like, when it comes along, you're like, please, 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 like, please, like, let's find the budget for it. It's just so amazing. And I don't want to let go of this show. So the fact that they're kind of like speeding ahead, and you can kind of see where it's going to come to a head, I think, in season three, if they green light season three, please, 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 please green light season three. And you know, you're just like, that's probably why they have to rush. Whereas I'm just like, please take your time. Take your time. Let's sit in this. Let's sit in this for a really long time. Just the little discourses between all the different vying and fighting factions within this family, the Julie Claudii. It's the formation of their empire. And oh man, like, I don't want to leave it. It's nonstop. It's from the first episode, you know, the backstabbing and the traitors and the villainy and the murders. It's all there, and it doesn't stop from episode one all the way to the end. I think there are 8 episodes each season, and I was never bored the entire time. I want to talk about a little bit of the cast members, because the other part of this series that makes it so great is the cast of it. It's just, they're very, very good. They're amazing at their roles. It's like they were just designed for these roles. Cassius Mutniak plays Livia Drusilla, the main character. The Matthew McNulty plays Gaius, Gaius Caesar. And Ben Bat plays Agrippa, his best friend. And he's really, really good. So compelling an actor. His scenes are just like, you're just hanging on every word he says, because he's so, as a best friend to you know, a wannabe emperor of Rome, you know, you can see how his loyalty is conflicted with his jealousy versus, you know, what he feels like his role is within this dynasty, because he's not the son of, he can't inherit, he's not necessarily going to inherit the power. And so it's just always this like tension between Gaius and Agrippa about, you know, I made you who you are, versus like, I'm still loyal to you as a best friend, and just them constantly trying to work that out. And then, you know, Livia being in the middle of it, fantastic dynamic, incredible character conflicts, just well done. And then Claire Forlani, which I recognize as an actress, plays Octavia, Gaius's sister, who has an enormous role within this series as well. And even Isabella Rossellini makes an appearance. And I was like, oh, I didn't really check and see if you can spot her, what character she plays. I was actually pretty shocked about that. The younger cast, all amazing as well. The ones that play the sons and the daughters of all these characters who are basically being used as pawns in this massive power play, they're all super compelling. The stuff about Rome that I feel like is a shame that's neglected is that these people are crazy. The history of Rome is cray-cray. The characters don't even need to be written, because history was insane. You know how they say truth is stranger than fiction? This is, you know, with the case of, especially when you start to get into the emperors of Rome, you get some insane stuff. You get people like dressing up concubines as their mothers, and you have obviously tons of treachery, tons of plotting, lots of inbreeding, which I think may have added to the craziness. So I would love to see this series continue, you know, if past it being Domina, go back to, you know, he can be Dominus, I don't care. But I would definitely check out Domina. It is on MGM Plus for those of us in the US. However, MGM Plus is only $5.99 a month. So for me, I definitely think that this show is worth $5.99. Get MGM Plus for the month, cancel it, boom, you've had 16 episodes of amazing content for $5.99. I mean, who's gonna argue with that? I do really wish it had been picked up by HBO or Netflix, but unfortunately, that's just the way it is. All right, guys, I hope you guys check out Domina. I am actually going to play the trailer on the back end here before I leave out. But for copyright reasons, I'm gonna just have it right here. And so we're gonna play it and I'm gonna watch it with you so that, you know, I hope I can hook you in. Okay, and roll trailer.
Marriage and children are what Rome expects of you.
Yep, young
Gaius,
no,
I think it'll ask
young
something
Livia.
else. Our
Oh,
family
yes, I
fortune
forgot.
stems from
Liam
└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└př Girl, will
don't
come
be fooled.
in the end.
That's the older version of Livia.
Guys want to give back power. Like Caesar has defying the Senate. Anything could happen.
Gaius, who's power
People
hungry.
are sick of war. They'll take a
That's
dictator
Agrippa.
In return for peace.
I don't want to be a dictator. I want to be
Yep.
a god.
So I found the way.
That's
the
Livia's best
Republic
friend, who she
destroys.
has a lot of plotting with.
I need you to understand. Husbands and wives, mothers and
yes.
children, poison and blood.
The intrigue.
There's
That's
no
Octavia,
end.
Gaius' sister.
All those whispered little secrets. This isn't about protecting the boys.
All the
this
politics.
It's about power.
Backstabbing.
It's about everything.
Livia Drusilla, this is a very dangerous game.
You take it all for granted. You think it's your birthright. It can be stolen from you in a moment.
Julia,
As
Gaius' daughter.
You really want to gamble?
Plays a pretty big
everything
role.
On this. We're loading the dice.
Cheer up, Agrippa. If it doesn't work, you can always kill everyone. I am the daughter of Marcus Livius Drusus. I don't break my word, and I don't run.
Have you restored power to the Senate yet?
I'm trying, Father.
Are you? Are you really? Or have you secretly fallen in love with your power?
Yep. I want other people to talk to about this show as well, because I feel like no one else watches it. And yeah, so it was a Sky original, which is in the UK, or sorry, Europe. And so it's not well known here. And unfortunately, the US doesn't seem to take well to imports. I don't know what it is. It's like if it wasn't a show that was created in the US, then it doesn't tend to gain any popularity. A lot of European shows have a hard time finding audience here in the US, where I hope this finds an audience. And unfortunately, I think the being behind MGM Plus for the US is going to be a detriment to the show, but maybe it'll get picked up eventually by a more common net streaming network, which, oh my gosh, too many streaming services, right? All right, guys. Please check out Domina if you get a chance. Let me know what you guys think. And or if you have Sky overseas, I think you can check it out for free if you have this, if you have Sky. So that's very easily accessible. Let me know what you guys think. And thanks so much for watching, guys. And if you'd like to watch more, you can click right here or right here to watch more now. Until next time, see you on the flip side.